For the last 30 days, I've been doing something that's helped increase my productivity, improve my ability to regain creativity, and just overall bring back joy and elation in doing monotonous tasks. So in this video, I wanna dive into microdosing, my experience doing it 30 days, and what you can learn from it. And if you haven't already, make sure to press the subscribe button so you get notified when videos just like this come out in the future. Let's dive into it. Before I start this video, I do need to say I'm not endorsing drug use. I'm not saying that everybody should do anything, but I do want to give you my experiences because I think it is valuable to always learn from others' experience. About 30 days ago, I began the protocol of microdosing by James Fadiman, and the results have been pretty interesting to say the least. No, this isn't something where you're gonna come away with conclusive evidence of X or Y at the end, but it is something that allows you to turn inside to really figure out how your psyche works and how the productivity and different things throughout your day go hand in hand. Now, before we dive into that, I do need to go into a little bit of the science behind using psilocybin or LSD when it comes to something like microdosing. And for the complete research, I put a link in the description to a website that has everything about microdosing. So just go down there and check that out. Now, microdosing works on the brain by actually inactivating a few different serotonin receptors. And these are the ones that often lead to learned helplessness, which is what most people have nowadays, the form of self-helplessness, depression, you know, all these different things that make us feel like we can't do X, Y, or Z. We don't have creativity. We sit there, life is gray. And so it actually helps to deactivate those and increase the areas of the brain that lead to creativity, that lead to productive thought, that lead to joy and elation in just everyday tasks. So that is why I wanted to do this, because not only is psilocybin and things like that have been very beneficial in my life, but it's been something that has evolved over time, and I love nootropics. So when I heard about 4 years ago that people in Silicon Valley were using this brand new nootropic to do all those things that I mentioned before, I had to try it. It's something that I love to do, and I love to be the human guinea pig self-experimenter that I am. So, and here are the four benefits that I got from microdosing. Now, the first benefit is joy in doing, and that doesn't mean that I have joy in doing everything, but what it does mean is that the simple monotonous menial tasks that I would typically do throughout the day and that I have to do for attention labs, I felt joy. I didn't go, oh, I have to do this. This is what I've chose to do. This is who I am. And I'm doing this out of my own volition. So why would I feel like, oh, I have to do this, when in reality, I choose everything that I do. And this helped bring the joy back to, oh, I'm copying and pasting for an hour, whatever I have to do. Benefit number two, of course, is introspective time. So I live a busy life. And not necessarily busy where I'm moving all over, but busy where I do have to get a lot done during the day. So I use the agile task method in order to make sure my day is segmented into areas that I can actively get done daily. But what often ends up happening, and this happens to so many of us because so many things are external nowadays, is that we forget about introspect. We lose touch with our mind and our bodies. And when that starts to happen, we can feel a separation from what we're doing and who we are. And so what this has allowed me to do is to turn back into that introspect, to watch the watcher, as they say, and I'm gonna get more into that in benefit number four, and to really become introspective as I typically am. Benefit number three is elevated sensory experiences. So what that means is, unlike most of the time when we pick things up, when we taste things, when we do basically anything nowadays, we don't do it fully. But just the little bit of non-psychoactive, so there's no hallucinations, there's nothing like that, psilocybin, and I start to taste more fully again. I start to feel more fully. I start to feel things in my body when I'm doing my movement practice that I normally don't feel. And it's helping to not only regain neural connections, but actually increase neural connections and neurons themselves. And I'll get to that in a little bonus in a second, which then puts you in touch with the different senses and axons firing around the body. So quite literally, you do have better, more in-depth, and more full sensory experience. Benefit number four is actually the post-microdosing joy. And so the day after I take any form of psilocybin or LSD to microdose, and I do this every 3 days, so the following day after taking it, I often feel a lot more joy than normal walking around. I have a better sense in touch with nature, earth, and just everything around me. And I can actively watch the watcher. I'm pulled out of of this, oh, I gotta do adrenaline mindset, and pulled more into, wait, let's sit back and watch things. Why did I think that way? How can I make sure that I don't think that way or understand the reason that I started to think that way? And I think that's so important for us to have nowadays, but with the hectic nature of our culture, that's often something that is so difficult to do, to really slow down, look around, think about why you did something, and then change your behavior based on that. So a bonus for anybody who does want to try microdosing is to actually pair this with lion's mane. I use 4-sigmatic lion's mane because in studies they've shown that lion's mane paired with psilocybin mushrooms can actually increase and grow new neurons. So it's something that actually is beneficial for your brain. Now, some of you may be wondering, are there downsides? And I can give a few disadvantages that I've found, but nothing that actually pulls away from the benefits. So if, let's say, the benefits are plus 10, this is a minus 2. So you net plus 8, and in my mind, that's always better than just staying at base. So that would be having a stuffy nose the next day, being a lot more thirsty the day of, and, you know, not taking things as seriously for the next 3 to 4 hours after I do it. But none of those are necessarily disadvantages. They're just things that over time you realize and can adapt your ways of living in order to mitigate. So you can actually go probably to a plus 9 or a plus 10 if you can get rid of everything substantially. So that is my experience microdosing for 30 days. Put your experience microdosing in the comments below. Otherwise, I look forward to seeing you in a video soon.